is I'm going to choose an element, and I'm going to ask you for a short period of time, when I'm doing that direction, to close your eyes and to become one with that element. It's an aspect of shape-shifting, and this particular book uses the tool of shape-shifting to help us move from ego to essence. So if you're all prepared, also I'm going to ask you another favor. We'll probably take a break after the talk. I'm going to ask you to turn your cell phones off and keep them off until we're all done today. And the reason being is that when we take a break and we're immediately on our cell phones again, we're breaking the energy. And I'd like to hold us in that heart space where we're, as John said, if he observed at the airport, you know, we're really connecting at that heart level. We're not thinking, we're not judging. We're just being heart. We're being people of the heart. And so that's what I'd like for us to accomplish today, is to be people of the heart, to really touch our hearts and feel that inner fire, and feel that eternal part of ourselves as a connection through the group today. Okay? Right, so I'm going to start the bell. I may have to have you hold this while I do this, and then I'll come back. So just pass it around. First, and then you'll repeat body, speech, and mind.
Body, speech, and mind.
In perfect oneness.
I send my heart.
Along with the sound of this bell. May the heavens awaken.
From their forgetfulness.
And transcend. The path of all anxieties. And sorrows. Listening to the bell, I feel the afflictions on me, begin to dissolve. My mind is calm.
My body is relaxed.
A smile is born on my lips. Following the sound of the bell, I go back to the island of mindfulness, and in the garden of my heart, the flowers of peace bloom beautifully. Now, I'm going to face the east, and so if you'll bring your attention to the east and close your eyes, I'm going to call on the spirits of the east. Spirits of the East, I invite you into our circle on this beautiful spring day and invite you to move each of us into a deeper connection with the element of Earth, which is an example here in Bellingham of Mott Baker. I'd like you to move your consciousness into a place where you become Earth, whether it's solid mountainous Earth or soft sand or it's simple dirt. I I want you to be Earth for a moment and think what it feels like to provide the stabilizing influence on our small planet. And think of the direction of the East as the direction where we gain clarity and wisdom and illumination. If you have an animal totem that represents the East, I'm going to invite you to call that animal in, to be part of our circle today, and to feel what it is to be that animal that walks the earth in a different way perhaps than we do, whether it's two-legged or four-legged or a creepy crawly. But let us just for a moment be the earth, feel this Mother Earth kind of energy, and see how we can contribute to that by being more aware and in touch with all of the gifts that are manifest from the earth, including our whole food chain and other materials that we use for shelter. So focusing on the East on this particular day in March, I invite you to simply be Earth. Move into that space deep within you where you are Earth, you are stable, and you are grounded, and you are strong, and you are here to provide us with this human experience. And so it is, luz, paz, amor, conciencia, harmonia. Now we're going to turn to the West. And in the West, since our great body of water is the Pacific Ocean, here I'm going to encourage us to move into that space of being water. So I would call to the spirits of the West. Spirits of the West, I invite you to join our circle today. We sit near a great body of water. And so I'm going to invite each of us to consider for a moment being water, whether we're still water, or we're rapids, or we're the ocean, or we're a pond, or we're the sea, or a creek flowing. Understand that water runs through us, much as the other elements, our bones are our earth, our blood is our water. So I invite you to begin to see water as a part of you that's flowing through. When we have flow, our emotions tend to not be so attached. They're able to detach. So choose a body of water right now that you'd like to experience. You'd like to feel the weight of it, the flow of it, the feeling of the washing factor of it, and allow yourself to move into that space. So understand some of the lessons of the West are about experience, introspection, and strength. So we're going to move into that inward space because this is the direction of the illusion also. While the East is illumination, the West is the illusion. And today, we'd like to take a particular time to begin to lift those seven veils of illusion that we might move into that becoming people of the heart. So be water for a moment. Into the north, the direction of the ancestors. And in the north, we're going to call in the ancestors, and we're also going to call in the element of air. A lot of our currents here in Bellingham come from Canada, the north. So I'll invite you to be air. Spirits of the north, our ancestors, all those who walked this plane, who traveled the waters, who felt the movement of the air, join us in our sacred circle today, our circle of the heart, and teach us about how air can lighten us, Our hair can shift our attention, and by shifting our attention, we can also redirect our magical intention. So I invite you to use this element of air for cleansing, purification, and renewal, and to become air, whether that's still air, or it's rapidly moving air, or it's a hurricane, whatever air is expressed, a gentle breeze, the trees swaying. Allow yourself for a moment to become air, to feel what it's like. And we have air every breath we take. We're breathing in air, we're moving this oxygen around to oxygenate our cells and to illumine our minds. So let us, in this direction of wisdom, ask air perhaps to become part of us now. And also invite it to give us a message today. What is the main message that we want to take away today as we work on lifting these veils of illusion? So for a moment, just be air. Be air in all its expressions, or whichever one you're most drawn to. Allow yourself to be air and to breathe. Sometimes when we experience a being from the other side, or we reconnect with those of our family who stepped through the veil, we may feel a little movement around us. We may feel a little breeze or air or a scent carried on the air that reminds us of that person. So when we are being air, we are sometimes freer to make those connections. And so it is. Use, pause, more.